In this video, I'm going to be overclocking the RTX 3070 to see if we can tie the 3070 Ti in gaming performance. Now, I only have a 3070, so I'm going to be testing that in this video, and I'm going to be running that across three different games on stock settings and overclock settings. Now, I don't have a 3070 Ti, but according to Tech Power Up reviews, that card does 3% better at 1080p, 5% better at 1440p, and 7% better at 4K. So I thought it'd be really interesting to see if we can close the gap, seeing as the specs of the 3070 are really close to the 3070 Ti. Okay, if you like this video, make sure to click the like button and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. And we have a Discord server now, so come along, join us there, and I'll leave a link in the description below.
Now we're adding a Ti to this class of GeForce, with more cores and super fast G6X memory. Today we're announcing the all new RTX 3070 Ti. It's one and a half.
Okay, so the first thing I want to do is take a look at the 3070 Ti specs and performance, and I'm going to call it Ti now because it just feels too weird to call it a Ti. Now, I'll just quickly run through the main differences using the table from video cards. The RTX 3070 has 5,888 CUDA cores. The 3070 Ti has 6,144. So that's about 4.3% difference. The boost clock for the RTX 3070 runs at 1,725 MHz, and the 3070 Ti runs at 1,770 MHz, which is about 2% difference. Now, the 3070 runs regularly at around 1,950 to 2,000 MHz, so I'm not sure how much the boost clock increase on the 3070 Ti is really going to affect performance, given the cards seem to top out at around 2,000 MHz. Finally, the biggest difference is, of course, the memory bandwidth. Nvidia opted to use G6X memory in the 3070 Ti versus G6 memory in the 3070, which meant the 3070 memory bandwidth was 448 GB/s versus 608 GB/s in the 3070 Ti. That's a big difference of about 36%, though, as you'll see in the reviews, it didn't end up improving performance that much. Looking at the Tech Power Up review for the Founders Edition of 3070 Ti, at 1080p there was a difference of about 3% on the 3070, at 1440p 5%, and at 4K it was 7%. These are averages across their suite of games, so there are going to be some games that perform better and some games that are going to perform worse. So, for the RTX 3070, I'll be using a Gigabyte RTX 3070 gaming OC. Now, I don't have a 3070 Ti, I'm just trying to see if I can get 6-7% better at 4K on the 3070 by overclocking it. Now, I hope this isn't a bit of a letdown, but I was a bit disappointed to learn that in MSI Afterburner, the Gigabyte RTX 3070 gaming OC's power limit has been locked to 100%. Now, this differs from card to card, but the gaming OC power limit can't be increased unless you install a VBIOS that lets you unlock it. So I'm happy with the way the card is, so I won't be installing the VBIOS. Now, the Gigabyte RTX 3070 has a 6-pin and 8-pin adapter. The 6-pin only supports up to 75 watts of power. The 8-pin is suited for 150 watts, I believe. So this card is probably performing at its limit anyway. Now, I'm not sure why the power limit has been locked. Maybe the higher end cards like the ASUS Strix or the Gigabyte Aorus Extreme have a higher limit, so perhaps you can get a bit more performance out of your card than mine. Let me know in the comments below if you can adjust your power limit on your 3070. So the only two other options I have to improve performance is to increase the fan speed and increase the memory clocks, which is what we'll be doing in this video. For testing today, I did testing on three games: Red Dead Redemption 2, Metro Exodus Enhanced Edition, and Forza Horizon 4. I chose these games specifically because they all had a benchmark mode, which made it easier to get similar test runs. I tested at 1080p, 1440p, and 4K resolutions at stock and overclock settings. And I did three test runs per setting and averaged the results just to even out the results a bit. The test system is as shown on the screen right now and is in the description below. For stock settings, this was essentially hitting the refresh button on MSI Afterburner to return to stock settings. This also includes a default fan curve as shown. For overclock settings, as mentioned before, the power limit couldn't be adjusted. The Gigabyte gaming OC still runs at 260 watts most of the time anyway, and given the TDP for the 3070 is actually 225 watts, so it's effectively an overclock anyway. I also increased the fan curve to operate at 100% and increased the memory clock by 1000 MHz. Increasing to 1200 MHz gave me errors. At 1000 MHz, this translates to 16 gigabits per second memory speed on the 3070, which works out to be about 512 gigabytes per second memory bandwidth. So we've cut a bit into the 3070 Ti memory bandwidth lead. Alright, let's check out some results. For Red Dead Redemption 2, there was a noticeable improvement at all resolutions. Here's a graph of the average frame rate for each resolution and setting. For 1080p, there was a difference of about 4.2%. At 1440p, a difference of 3.8%, and at 4K, a difference of 5.5%. Now, looking at Tech Power-Up's 3070 Ti review, even though it's not directly comparable because it's a different test system and their test run is unknown, the 3070 Ti was 12% stronger at 4K in Red Dead Redemption 2. So it is interesting that just by increasing the memory clocks, we are able to claw back some ground on the 3070 Ti. Here are the minimum and maximum frame rates for those interested. In Metro Exodus, there was an improvement at all resolutions, but the difference was similar across the resolutions. At 1080p, it was 2.7%, 1440p 2.9%, and 4K was 2.7%. I do believe that at higher resolutions, you should benefit more from memory overclocking and memory bandwidth. As you can see, the 4K average frame rates are in their low 20s, so even a 0.5 FPS margin could improve the difference by 2.5%. So, while there is a small difference here, in terms of real-world difference, it's probably not going to be noticeable. Once again, here are the minimum and maximum frame rates for those interested. In Forza Horizon 4, the benchmark produces an achieved FPS, and that's because they also include a GPU average frame rate, which they've separated this out from the CPU render frame rate. At lower resolutions, such as 1080p, you can see that the CPU bottlenecks the frame rate. Here, there's not much difference at 1080p, mostly because of the CPU bottleneck. At 1440p, there's a difference of 2.8%, and at 4K, it's 4% difference. It's not really that significant, and personally I wouldn't bother overclocking given the increased fan noise and memory running hotter due to higher speeds. Overall, from increasing the memory clocks by 1000 MHz or effectively increasing another 60 GB per second memory bandwidth, the performance of the 3070 increased by 2.4% at 1080p, 3.2% at 1440p, and 4.1% at 4K. In real-world circumstances, I personally wouldn't bother overclocking the 3070, especially when the power limit is locked and RTX 30 cards don't overclock past 2000 MHz very well anyway. It is interesting that the 3070 Ti is about 7% difference at 4K, and honestly, not very impressive performance increase from the 3070. Which brings me back to discussing the 3070 Ti. A lot of the discussion online has been about how relatively unimpressive the GPU is compared to other offerings like the 3070 or the 3080 or AMD's cars like the RX 6800. But that's not going to matter all that much given there's just a lack of graphics cards right now. And the 3070 Ti could have a negative performance improvement and people would still buy the card. So relatively speaking, if the 3070 and the 3070 Ti were both available, then you should only expect to pay 7% more for the 7% improvement gain. But there are other downsides to the 3070 Ti as well. It has a much higher power draw at 290 watts, and there's relatively little performance gain for that increase of power. So ultimately, I feel like the 3070 is the better card overall. Okay, so if you like this video, make sure to click the like button and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. And I'll see you in the next one.